So I think Spicebomb is a modern classic, and I think Spicebomb Extreme is an extremely mass appealing compliment getter. But how good is the new Spicebomb Infrared? Let's find out. Hi, welcome to Rotten Rebel. If you're brand new here, then you gotta make sure to hit that subscribe and that notification bell, and please do drop a like on this video. Thank you. So in this video, I am going to take a closer sniff on the brand new Spicebomb Infrared from Viktor and Rolf. So how does it smell? There's no spice bomb without those spices, and straight away I get a beautiful dose of cinnamon, pepper and saffron together with something sweet. That opening is so good. I really enjoy that bright and spicy opening, and I love how the pepper blends with the saffron and cinnamon. As it dries down, the whole scent turns into a blend of tobacco with a fruity sweetness. The sweetness, at least to my nose, is something fruity with something that leans towards vanilla, and it's just so damn good. You can clearly feel the original in this one, but to my nose, the original scent profile is pushed a bit into the background by that added fruity sweetness, and I just love it. Infrared to me is right in the middle of the original and Extreme. It's definitely sweeter than the original, but not as heavy as Extreme, and with a different kind of sweetness than Extreme. Infrared gives me a flirty and sexy kind of vibe, and I will definitely use it when I'm going on dates or when I'm going out with my friends, or simply when I want a fantastic, spicy, fruity and sweet fragrance with a sexy vibe. The first time I got a whiff of Infrared was when I did a fragrance haul with Sandra Solomon Fragrance. I'm gonna link to that fragrance haul above. As soon as she got a whiff of it, she loved it. A few days ago, I received a compliment from the receptionist at the gym, and later that same evening when I had friends over for dinner, I received another compliment for it. This is a compliment getter for sure, and I think that this is going to beat both the original and Extreme when it comes to compliments, simply because it walks the line right in between both of them when it comes to the spiciness and the sweetness. The performance on my skin is above average, but not beast mode. About 8 sprays gave me a good enough projection for other people to pick it up, and a decent longevity with about 4 to 5 hours. I think it's versatile enough to be used in most situations, and I also think that you can use it throughout the year. Yup, I am definitely going to use it throughout the year, and I can't wait to use it for those summer night outs. So who is Infrared for? Think of it as a fragrance that sits right in the middle of the original and Extreme. You can clearly feel the original in it, but it's more sweet, and the sweetness, at least to my nose, is something fruity with something vanillic. So if you love the original and think you would enjoy a sweeter version of it, then you might like this one. If you love Spicebomb Extreme, then you might end up loving this one as well, as long as you enjoy a fruity kind of sweetness. Do not get this one if you don't enjoy spicy, sweet and fruity blends. I really like Infrared. No, scratch that. I love Infrared, and I really enjoy that I now have a new version of Spicebomb that gives me a bit of the original but with a twist, and I absolutely love the vibe I get when I put it on. I am going to give Spicebomb Infrared 8.5. I think it's a worthy flanker to that now modern classic Spicebomb, and I highly recommend it to you. I would love to know how you feel about Spicebomb Infrared. Please do comment and let me know. If you enjoyed this review, then I would highly appreciate if you would like it. Don't forget to hit that subscribe and that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.